Hello world, it's Siraj. In this episode, we're gonna build an image classifier using TensorFlow in 30 lines of Python. And I don't mean a classifier that can detect handwritten digits or iris flowers. I'm talking literally anything you want. You'll be able to train this thing to classify chocolate if you wanted. The possibilities are endless. There's so many industries that can be disrupted by just this simple solution. A Japanese cucumber farmer built a machine to detect whether each of his cucumbers was one of 9 different types using this thing. Let's say we want to build a Siraj classifier. If we think about this problem in the traditional programming paradigm, we want to handcraft a bunch of features. Maybe we could do some edge detection to save the shape of my hair, or use a color histogram to save the color of my teeth. The problem with that is, there's so much variance in Sirajas. My hair is alive. Seriously, it's never the same. This is where convolutional neural networks come into play. They're essentially a black box that constructs features that we would otherwise have to handcraft. And these abstract features they create from training are so generalized that they account for variance. If we wanted to train a CNN ourselves, we need a lot of computing power and a lot of time, both of which we don't have. I don't even have time to do my dishes. Sorry, roommates. That's why we'll want to use a pre-trained CNN model called Inception. Inception was trained by Google on 100K images with 1,000 categories. Our use case in this video will be classifying Darth Vader pictures. But Inception wasn't trained on Vader, so we're going to perform a process called transfer learning. That means applying the learnings from a previous training session to a new training session. If we look at the Inception model, we can see that when we feed in an image as an input at each layer, it will perform a series of operations on that data until it outputs a label and classification percentage. Each layer is a different set of abstractions. In the first layers, it's basically taught itself edge detection, then shape detection in the middle layers, and they get increasingly more abstract up until the end. If we look at the last few layers, these are the highest level detectors for whole objects. For transfer learning, we'll basically just want to retrain that last layer on features of Darth Vader so it can add a representation of him to its repository of knowledge. So this is going to be a 7-step process, and we're going to go through each step in order. Sound good? Step 1 is to install Docker, which is a tool for creating a virtual container on your machine for running apps. The benefit of Docker is you don't have to install any dependencies on your machine. So we'll eventually download a Docker image that has all the necessary dependencies for TensorFlow built in. Just download the Docker toolbox, go through the installation process, and then you can launch your Docker container anytime easily by double-clicking the Docker Quick Start terminal. Cool. Now that we have Docker open, that brings us to step 2, installing the TensorFlow Docker image by pasting in this line. It'll take a few minutes, then once it's installed, we'll move on to step 3, downloading our image dataset to our local machine. We'll stop Docker with Control D, then create a directory called tf_file/StarWars in our home directory locally. We'll want to put a folder labeled Darth Vader that contains a couple hundred Vader pics in here. There's this dope Chrome extension I found called fatcun batch download image that bulk downloads all the images from your Google image search results. Just go to Google image search, type in Darth Vader, and start downloading all of those images. Once we've got them, we'll just drag that folder into our tf_file/StarWars folder. That brings us to step 4. Now that we have our images in our tf files directory, we'll want to link them to our Docker container with this command. Boom, all linked up. Step 5 is to download the training script via Git. Just cd into the TensorFlow directory, then run git pull. This code will allow us to retrain the Inception classifier with our newly linked Darth Vader image dataset. Step 6 is the actual retraining part. The bottleneck directory will be used to cache the outputs of the lower layers on disk so they don't have to repeatedly be recalculated. We'll run this example for 500 iterations. The next flag asks where to store our trained model, our output graph, which we can later view in TensorBoard, our output labels, which will be the same as our training data folder name, and the image directory where we stored our Vader images. Let's go ahead and run the script right from terminal. It'll take about 30 minutes or so to train our classifier, so do something productive. The script should output a training accuracy somewhere between 85 and 99% when it's done. And this brings us to our final step. We want to write a script that will use our new retrained classifier to detect if a novel image contains Darth Vader. We'll write the script ourselves. First things first, we'll import TensorFlow. Then we'll want to create a variable to store the user input image path. We'll create another variable to store the data from that image, and one more to load the label of that image from the label file. Next, we'll want to grab our model from the saved retrained graph file, store it in the graph def variable, and parse it. Now that we have our image and model ready, it's time to make our prediction by feeding the image data into our retrained model to get our prediction output. In order to do this, we'll create a TensorFlow session. This will give us an environment to perform operations on our tensor data in. The first thing we'll do in a session is get our softmax function tensor from the last layer of our model. The softmax function is used in the final layer to map input data into probabilities of an expected output. We will execute our softmax tensor function on our input image data via the session run function. It will output our predictions as an array. We'll next want to sort our prediction labels in order of confidence, and lastly, for every prediction we have, we can get the predicted label and the score and print it out to terminal. Let's take the script and run it on one of our Vader pictures. The result is pretty good. TensorFlow makes it much easier to classify an image, and I've got a challenge for you guys on this episode. The challenge is to create a classifier that you think would be a useful tool for scientists to have. It can be any field of science you'd like. Upload your code to GitHub, and in the README, write up a few sentences on how a scientist would use this. Post a repository in the comment section, and I'll judge them based on utility and accuracy. The winner gets a shout out from me 2 videos from now, so in 2 weeks, and I'll also send you a free signed copy of my book, Decentralized Applications. For now, I've got to go not buy the iPhone 7, so thanks for watching.